Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you how to make a music visualizer in Apple Motion. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So Apple Motion is a tool that Apple sells for $50 in the App Store. It's usually thought of as an add-on to Final Cut Pro, but you could also actually use it to create transparent video and use it in iMovie as well. A really cool thing that you can do in Motion is create music visualizers. So graphic elements that react to the sounds of an audio track. And it's actually pretty simple to do if you're just a little bit familiar with Motion. This probably isn't the video to get you into Motion in the first place, but if you know a little bit, this will show you how to create a music visualizer pretty easily, and then you could export that and use that in some video project.
Let's create a Motion project, which will just create a video, and then maybe, you know, if you wanted to go pretty far, you could make that semi-transparent or make it green screen and bring it into, you know, iMovie or something. I'm just going to create a Motion project. And if you're not familiar with Motion, it's a really cool app, but this probably isn't the tutorial that's going to bring you into it because it's very complex. This will give you an idea of what's possible, and if you are into Motion, this will give you an idea of like how do you do this audio thing, like actually have an item react to audio. All I'm going to do here is I'm going to take the default group and I'm going to add a shape to it. I'm going to add a circle. And think of this as like a speaker or something on the screen. So I'm going to draw a circle in the video. And so now I've got my group with the circle in it. So far so good. So with the circle selected, I'm going to go to the inspector here. Let's add the music. So I'll drag and drop a music file in. Just stick it in here. And then you see it's got the music sample. If I now play this, it's just my music with a circle that just sits there and does nothing. So let's go back to the beginning here. And with the circle selected, I can go to the inspector. And then there are different properties, like the shape properties. Properties here, like the scale. And it'll be neat if, you know, instead of 100%, this kind of like got bigger and smaller as the music played. To do that, I can control this number using something like this. If I click here, there's a parameter. I can add a behavior parameter, and sure enough, the very first one is audio. So I'll say audio. Then it's going to go to this behaviors thing. So I still have properties and behaviors and filters and shape and all that. But under behaviors now I've got this audio behavior, and the first thing I need to do is assign a source. So you can see music sample is the only source that's there. So it's going to tie it in. And then it's going to give me this audio graph here. And here's an equalizer. And as I move the timeline, you can see the equalizer change. So I can get an idea of what parts of the audio are changing. And I know I've got this bass track, and it'd be nice to have this, you know, bounce to the bass track. So I'm going to just say, you know, just an area right around here. Pay attention to that area. And then I can also do a vertical area too. So if it's not really going up that high, I can have this react to something a little bit more in there. And now if I move this along, you could see the scale is going to change based on the music that's playing in this part at these frequencies. So that's exactly what I want. Let's rewind and play. So there, you can see just a couple of minutes I showed you how to do something really cool. And let's duplicate this. I'll go here, do duplicate. And in this one, it's got the same thing. There's two of them. Let's actually move this away. And this one here, for audio, I'm going to change the frequency and say let's go up something high like that. And maybe like here, because eventually it starts to play a little bit of a keyboard. So you can see this isn't moving here. So you can see this is reacting more to that sound there. You know, further go over here, let's select this and go into behaviors. And you can see it here. So when we start to play, the keyboard comes in, you can see it really starts to move this part of that. So I can, you know, take this filter down a little bit more. And there are all sorts of other things you could do. You know, you could set a floor and the floor and ceiling are those, the frequencies are those. But you could do a smoothness. You could do, you know, do you want sharp peaks, smooth peaks? Do you want it to add, subtract, or multiply to the scale? So let's change both of these here to multiply. And then instead of going 100% and then up, it's like going from zero on. So now you get this. So there's so many more things that you could do. One of the things that you could do is you could have kind of an equalizer effect. Let's create another group here, new group, and let's create a line. Draw a line like that, and under the properties for that line, we could change the scale to the audio behavior there, and set it to music sample. And let's set it down to here for the scale. And we do that. But here's the thing is I could duplicate this. Option drag, make a second copy of it. Well, let's just create a bunch of them. You know, I see all these audio ones here. So that's the audio for this one. This one, let's go to the bottom here. So that's the first one. Second one. And let's have it go to this. And third one, go to this. And fourth one, etc. So we're building a little on-screen equalizer. And I think we got one more. So now we could play this. So that's like an equalizer. And now another cool thing that you could do is we can, let's create another group here. And this is the last example I'll show you. In this group, I'm going to draw a line, just like before, like that. And then I'm going to set the shape here of the line to width to 1, so it's just a line like that. And I'm going to, with this selected, this line selected, I'm going to do object, and I'm going to make particles. So this is going to be particles now. So it's just going to do this, like a little particle generator. I need to move this over. Let's do the whole group here. Move it over here. I committed the sin in motion of not starting at the beginning. That's always hard to kind of recover. But you can see it's just emitting these particles. Okay, so let's control these particles a little bit more here. In the emitter, let's say the emission range is 0. So now, it's emitting them out to the right. Okay, and let's do the birth rate, something smaller, like 10. We can actually go out here and we could see it's throwing out these lines. And then let's go to the scale here. So we have the scale, and let's add the audio to this as the scale. Yeah, there we go. So each one that's being emitted now is being emitted at a scale based on what it's finding in the music here. So we could go, you know, back to like, let's do it for this section here and that area. So now let's go further into the behaviors here, and you see it says apply to object scale. We can get more specific here. I could say let's apply to scale only Y. So it's not going to make it thicker. It'll just make it taller. And then let's, instead of apply add, let's apply multiply. So it's 0 when it's 0 and multiplies it based on that. So now so there's a whole bunch of different ways that you could have fun here with audio visualizers in Motion. And then, of course, if you create this project here as a transparent background, make this the color that you want, you can tie this to the music and export it with the music and kind of a semi-transparent music visualizer, and then put that in iMovie, and then put a picture-in-picture or cutaway over on top of that, or actually make this the cutaway on top since it's semi-transparent. And then you can create one of these as a cool visualizer on top of iMovie. And of course, in Final Cut, you can have as many layers as you want. So you could have this as a layer and then music and then other things.
So Apple Motion has a ton of different settings, different particle effects and replicators and all sorts of things. And you could tie a lot of those into the audio that's playing. So really you could just play around with this all day long and come up with new music visualizer types to use in your projects. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.
If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.